Okay, good morning in grade 10. So for today, we will have lesson number 2 for the 4th grading period, and that will be about the general form of the equation of the circle. So in our previous discussion, what we have discussed is the standard form of the equation of the circle. And the standard form of the equation of the circle is given by x minus h squared plus y minus k squared is equal to r squared. So another name for this form of the equation of the circle is what we call as the center radius form. So this one po si standard form ay pwede rin natin natawagin na center radius form. Now, si center radius form, bakit siya tinawag na ganoon? Bakit tinawag na center radius form si standard form of the equation of the circle? So the reason behind doon is, di ba, center. Ibig sabihin, coming from this equation, pwede nating ma-determine yung coordinates ng center ng circle, di ba, that is denoted by h and k, and the length of the radius. So kaya po tinawag din na center radius form si standard form of the equation of the circle. Okay po. Now, doon naman tayo sa lesson for today. So, for today's lesson, we will have the general form of the equation of the circle. So, what we are going to do is, given the standard form, or pwede rin siguro kung given ay center at radius lang, from that given, hahanapin po natin, or we need to convert or to transform that specific equation to the general form of the equation of the circle. Now, what is the general form ng equation ng circle? Kung sa standard form ay merong x minus h squared plus y minus k squared is equal to r squared, for the general form naman, we will have x squared plus y squared plus dx plus ey plus f is equal to 0, wherein si d, e, and f are all constants, or those are real numbers. Then, paano natin magagawa? Let's say for example, na si standard form na given by this equation ay gagawin natin general form. So going back to our lesson yesterday, di ba, what was the lesson? It is about squaring a binomial using the special products and performing or multiplying binomials using the FOIL method. So if you will see kasi grader, if you will observe closely, the standard form of the equation of the circle is composed of two binomials. Diba, binomials are polynomials na dalawa ang terms. So it is composed of two binomials raised to the second power. And alam naman natin, di ba, na if a binomial is raised to the second power, let's say for example, si x minus h squared, si x minus h squared is just the same with x minus h times x minus h. So, kung ganito, di ba, pwedeng gamitan niya ng FOIL method or using special products. Now, let's have examples para mas madali pong maintindihan. So, for example, number 1, so we have here x minus 2 squared plus y minus 3 squared is equal to 45. Now this is an example ng standard form of the equation of the circle. Ito yung tinatawag natin na center radius form. So maging parang routine nyo na, na kapag given ang standard form or whatever equation ng circle, lagi ko pong pinapahanap muna is yung center and radius. Diba? So, center muna tayo. Diba, the center is denoted by h and k. Ang h ay laging kasama ni x, si k ay laging kasama ni y. And this is r squared. So, h, negative 2. Opposite of negative 2, babalik na rin ang sign. So, h will be positive 2. And k, negative 3 dito. Papalitan ng sign, yung kabaliktaran, so this will be positive 3. So the center or the coordinates of the center of the circle na may ganitong equation is located at positive 2 and positive 3. Next, we need to get the length of the radius. In our equation, yung naka-equate siya sa r squared. Eh, ang kailangan natin is just r. So, that means kung r squared to, kailangan natin kuhanin yung square root. So, that means square root of 45, diba hindi siya pwedeng makuha na exacto. So, this is the square root of factor out natin, that is 9 times 5. And since 9 is a perfect square, so we will have 3 square root of 5 units. Now, sa schoology po ay hindi pwede naman na magkaroon tayo ng may radical sign, so mahihirapan na kayo mag-type. So what we need to do is to get the decimal na value ng square root ng 45, and that is 6.71. So katulad ba rin po dati? So the radius is 6.71 units. Okay po, center 2 and 3, length of the radius 6.71 units. But hindi pa tayo tapos, di ba? Ang kailangan natin is the general form of the equation of the circle. So that means grade 10, ang gagawin lang po natin to convert that is to perform the following operations. Kailangan lang natin i-square yung binomial or i-multiply using the FOIL method. So in this case, in this example, kay x minus 2 squared, ang gagamitin ko ay yung special products. Kay y minus 3 squared ay si FOIL method. Pero pag kayo ang nagsosolve, depende na po sa inyo. If you will use yung FOIL method or yung special products on both binomials po ng ating equation ng circle. So again, gamitin po natin yung special products for the first part of the equation. So x minus 2 squared. So for special products, again, ano yung tatlong steps? For the first one is square the first term. The first term in our equation is x. X raised to the second power will give us x squared. Then, next po is twice the product of the first and the second term. So, twice daw ng product ng first and second term. First term is x, second term is negative 2. So, x times negative 2 will give us negative 2x. Then, times 2 will give us negative 4x. Then, the third step is to square the second term. The second term is negative 2. Negative 2 times negative 2 or negative 2 raised to 2. That is positive 4. Again, grade 10, when there is a negative number raised to n exponents, kapag sa calculator po, paka-enclose ng parentheses. So we have si x minus 2 squared as x squared minus 4x plus 4. So next naman po is kuhanin natin yung sa y minus 3 squared. So gamitin naman natin is yung FOIL method. Again, si y minus 3 squared ay pwedeng i-express as the product of y minus 3 times y minus 3. Following the FOIL method, first terms, again, FOIL method po tayo. So first term is y times y squared. Outer terms, y times negative 3 is negative 3y. Then inner, negative 3 times y is negative 3y. Then negative 3 times negative 3. Last terms ay positive 9. Combine like terms, you will have y squared minus negative 3 plus negative 3 is negative 6. Break down y plus 9. So si y minus 3 squared is equal to positive or plus y squared minus 6y plus 9. Next naman po, going back, balik tayo doon sa slide. Next naman po, diba, naka-equate sa 0 si general form. So since naka-equate sa 0 si general form, that means kailangan nating alisin si negative 45 dito, or si positive 45. So, gagawin natin yung positive 45, ililipat natin sa kabilang side ng equal sign. So, from positive, siya ay magiging negative. So, we will have negative 45 and it is now equal to 0. So, next, anong susunod natin gagawin? So, the next thing that you need to do is to rearrange the terms. Diba, si general form ng equation ng circle is all sa inalim. Diba, siya ay si x squared plus y squared plus dx plus ey plus f equals 0. So, rearrange lang natin. Unahin daw si x squared. Then, si y squared. Sunod ay yung merong x, that is negative 4x. So, minus 4x. Then, yung may y, that is negative 6y. Then, f or yung constant ay meron tayong tatlo. So, we have positive 4, positive 9, then negative 45. So, we need first to simplify. So, 4 plus 9 will give you 13 minus 45 will give you 30, negative 32, that equals 0. So that is greater than our general form of the equation of the circle. So this is our final answer. Okay, let's move with our second example. So for this one, for example number 2, we have x plus 4 squared plus y plus 7 squared is equal to 36. So again po, katulad nung kanina, let us have first the coordinates of the center and the length of the radius. So again, kapartner ni x, this is h, kapartner ni y is k, and this is r squared. So again, the center of the circle is denoted by h and k. So therefore, the center is at, if h dito is positive 4, babalik ta rin yung sign, so h is negative 4. K dito is positive 7, babalik ta rin dito ang sign, so we will have negative 7. Then, the length of the radius, eto ay r squared, kung si r squared ay equal sa 36 para makuha ang r, that means we need to get the square root. Cancel this. So, r is equal to square root of 36 is 6. So, we have the length of the radius is 6 units. Okay po? So, again, this equation na x plus 4 squared plus y plus 7 squared is equal to 36 ay may coordinates ng center na nasa negative 4, negative 7, and the length of the radius is 6 units. Now, let us convert this equation or let us transform this equation to the general form. So, again, it depends upon you. It depends upon you kung ano yung gagamitin nyo na method. So, para mas padali, doon na lang tayo kay special product. So, si x plus 4 squared, perform natin. So, this will be square the first term. So, x raised to 2, that is x squared. Then twice the product of the first and the second term. So 2 times x is 2x. Kasi twice daw. So 2 times x is 2x. 2x times 4 is positive 8x. Then square the second term. Positive 4 raised to 2 or positive 4 times positive 4 is positive 16. Plus, again, y plus 7 squared. So square the first term, y. Then twice the product of the first and the second term, y times 7 is 7y. 7y times 2 is positive 14y. Then squared the second term, 7 times 7 is positive 49. Then si positive 36, inilipat sa kabila. So from positive, siya ay magiging negative 36. Then equate that to 0. So next, rearrange yung terms. Again, unahin si x squared. This is y squared. Plus y squared. Plus yung may x. Plus 8x. Then yung may y, so plus 14y, then we will simplify those na constant or walang variable, si positive 16 plus 49 minus 36. So we have 16 plus 49 will give you 65, and 65 minus 36 is positive 29, then equals 0. So this is our final answer. This is the general form of the equation of the circle. So si x plus 4 squared plus y plus 7 squared is equal to 36 na nasa standard form. Kapag ginawa natin general form is magiging ito. Si x squared plus y squared plus 8x plus 14y plus 29 equals 0. Okay, let's have another example. So this is example number 3. So we have here x minus 2 squared plus y plus 8 squared is equal to 28. So again, center muna tayo. So center, h and k, this is h, this is k, invert, negative 2 yung h, so this will be positive 2. K is 8, positive 8, mabalik na rin yung sign, so ito ay magiging negative 8. So center is at positive 2, negative 8, and this is r squared. If r squared is equal to 28, so get the square root para makuha si r. Si 28 ay hindi pwedeng makuha ng eksaktong square root, so pwede siyang square root ng 4 times 7, and 4 is a perfect square, so r is equal to 2 square root of 7 units. So again, grade 10, hindi to pwede sa Schoology, so we need to get yung decimal format ng square root of 28, and that is our value ng r. So our radius ay si 2 square root of 7 units, or kapag ginawang decimal is equal to 5.29 units. Okay pa. Gagawin natin siyang general form. So kapag ginawa natin siyang general form, special product sa lang ulit ha, x minus 2 squared. First step, get the square of the first term, x. So x raised to 2, or x times x will give us x squared. Twice the product of the first and the second term para makuha yung susunod. So x times negative 2 is negative 2x. Negative 2x times 2 is negative 4x. Natandaan po grade na kapag sa second term nung trinomial na ginagawa natin, kung ano man yung sign sa gitna ng dalawang binomial, yun na rin yung sign ng second term. Okay po? So since ito ay minus, so yung second term ay negative 2. And negative 2 squared, again, dapat may parenthesis, so this is positive 4. Kasi negative 2 times negative 2 will give us a positive answer. So plus, si y plus 8 naman, y raised to 2, y squared, twice the product, y times 8, is 8y. 8y times 2 is positive 16y. Then, positive 8 raised to the second power is positive 64. Kasi 8 times 8 will give us 64. Then, si negative 28, ililipat sa kabila. So, from positive 28, siya ay magiging negative 28. Then, it is now equal to 0. Sunod, rearrange the terms. So we will have unahin si x squared followed by y squared, and then yung may x, so negative 4x followed by yung may y, so plus 16y. Then let us simplify or combine like terms. 4 plus 64 will give you 68, and 68 minus 28 is equal to positive 40. So again, this is the general form of the equation of the circle. We have x squared plus y squared minus 4x plus 16y plus 40 is equal to 0. Question so far, grade 10. Again, there is a comment box or there is a discussion board after this video. Pwede po kayo dong mag-post ng question so I can answer it right away. So, down with our last example. So, for our last example, we have the coordinates of the center of the circle is located at 0 and 5. And the length of the radius is 4 units. Now, ano yung iba sa example na to? Okay, for this example po, ang binigay sa inyo is the coordinates on the center and the length of the radius. Wala si standard form. O, paano yun? Kung wala si standard form, wala tayong magpa-perform ng special product o square of a binomial. So, ano yung dapat una natin gawin? Okay, that is correct. The first thing that we need to do is to determine first the standard form. And again, di ba ano yung standard form? Di ba si x minus h squared plus y minus k squared is equal to r squared. Sa center na 0 and 5, this is h, this is k, and obviously this is r. So plug in lang natin, invert the sign ha, do not forget. So we have here x minus h is 0, so copy 0 squared plus y. Our k is positive 5. Kabaliktaran ng sign ng positive 5. So, minus 5 squared is equal to, ang r is 4, so 4 squared. Hindi pa tayo tapos. So, since 0 naman yung h, so pwedeng directly na to, so this will be just equal to x squared. Kasi 0 naman yan. 0 na nga, di ba? Wala ng value, so hindi na siya kailangan ilagay. So, next, plus copy y minus 5 squared is equal to 4 squared, 4 times 4, 16. So, si x squared plus y minus 5 squared equals 16 is our standard form. Now, from the given standard form, kukuhanin na natin si center, ay si center at radius, si general form. So, again, we have x squared plus y minus 5 squared is equal to 16. So, we will now get the general form. So, since ito ay x squared na, so that means wala na tayong magagawa sa kanyang operation, so just copy x squared. Plus, since ito ay y minus 5 squared, so square of a binomial, square ng first term, square of y, y raised to 2, so y squared. Then, twice the product of the first and the second term, y times negative 5 is negative 5y. Negative 5y times 2. Again, negative 5y times 2 is negative 10y. Then square of the second term, negative 5 squared is positive 25. Then 16, babato ulit natin sa right, sa left side rather than equal sign. So from positive 16 magiging negative 16, then it is now equal to 0. Next, obviously, wala tayong i-rearrange kasi wala naman tayong x. So, as is na lang tayo dito, we will have x squared plus y squared minus 10y, then simplify the two constants. So, 25 minus 16 is positive 9. So, equals, so 0. So, we have the general form as x squared plus y squared, this is plus sa grade 10. So, x squared plus y squared minus 10y plus 9 equals 0. So, again, grade 10, that is the general form of the equation of the circle. Again, baka malimutan ha. Sulat ulit natin dito sa gilid. So, again po, si standard form ay x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. Next naman, si general form. O, di-discuss lang. General form, x squared plus y squared plus dx plus ey plus f equals 0. O ano pa? May isa pa tayo. Coordinates ng center, H and K. So again, that is lesson number 2. That is about the general form of the equation of the circle. So that is all for today, grade 10. Thank you and God bless.